I think if you were to ask a lot of Grand Theft Auto players, they would say their favorite protagonist is Carl C.J. Johnson from San Andreas. And today we're going to be taking a look at 8 Easter eggs and references that proves he's probably still alive today and might actually be living in Los Santos too.
I got Young Melee, man. Y'all know who Young Melee is, man. The world know who this motherfucker is, man. It's the nigga, man. Tell him who you is, nigga.
I'm CJ from San Andreas.
What's up, y'all?
What's up, CJ?
Live and direct. CJ and Franklin up in this motherfucker. Real life shit, though.
Welcome to San Andreas. I'm CJ from Grove Street. Land of the heinous gangbangers and cold meat. And Los Santos neighbors get no sleep. Beefing with anybody competing, even cold meat.
So if you weren't sure what that clip was right there, that actually ties into our first Easter egg today. And that is the voice actor and motion capture artist of Franklin is actually cousins with the voice actor and motion capture artist for CJ. What a small world, and honestly, what are the odds? So the voice actor for CJ is Young Melee, the voice actor for Franklin is Sean Fontano, and they are actually cousins, which is insane. What are the odds, man, that your cousin lands the protagonist for GTA San Andreas, and then a couple years later, you land the protagonist gig for Grand Theft Auto 5? I mean, I just think that is absolutely crazy. Now, I know Rockstar has funny rules and regulations about 3D characters appearing in the HD universe, but I think that if there was one character that might make a reappearance, it would definitely be CJ. Number one, due to his proximity in Los Santos, where we left off in GTA San Andreas. But also, number two, his relationship with Sean Fontana. Like, how easy would it to be to bring them back together and do a little scene? So I think that would be incredibly awesome. That's our first Easter egg today. In case you didn't know, even though Franklin and CJ, their characters, have no relationship, that's one of the biggest rumors of GTA 5. Their voice actors do. They're cousins and they're probably best friends as well. Now, one of the most famed but also most difficult missions in GTA San Andreas is where you have CJ and Big Smoke on a dirt bike following a train, and essentially you have to try and shoot off a lot of the bad guys that are on top of the train. It's one of the hardest missions in the GTA franchise, and if you fail the mission, you get this famous line from Big Smoke.
All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ. All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ. All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ.
Now, in Grand Theft Auto 5, there is a similar mission where you play as Trevor, and you essentially have to follow a train, get on top of it, but then take it over. Now, if you do that successfully, one of the mission achievements for this mission is called Better Than CJ, another really cool reference. Does it mean that after all these years, CJ is still trying to do and complete this mission and still trying to get the voice of Big Smoke out of his head? Who knows, but I thought this was a really cool reference to this mission. Again, it is the mission Derailed, and you can earn a gold achievement, which is Better Than CJ. Now, staying on that same subject, on the highway in Los Santos near the prison near Sandy Shores, there's actually a set of numbers written on the side of the highway. 125-820-423-620-420 and then -310. And what those numbers translate to are the letters in the alphabet. So number 1 would be A, 21 would be Y, 8 would be H, 20 would be T, etc., etc., etc. And what this actually turns out to be is that famous line that Big Smoke said so many years ago.
All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ. All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ. I'm about to pop these fools. All we had to do was follow the damn train, CJ.
And if you decode and translate all of it, it comes up to all you had to do was follow the damn train -CJ. So again, a really cool reference right there that someone has inscribed that Easter egg into the San Andreas Highway in GTA 5. Now, I'm not sure who would have gone about doing that. Maybe it was someone that was related to CJ. Maybe it was someone related to Big Smoke. Or maybe it was just someone commemorizing that epic saying and that awesome mission from San Andreas. Now, switching gears a little bit and moving to GTA 4, which took place in 2007 or 2008. So it looks like CJ might have actually gotten a modeling career for the company Frontalot, which is their slogans from the concrete jungle. You can clearly see there he's in a suit, he's drinking some sort of liqueur, and he's looking pretty good. So I would say that CJ possibly got a nice career in advertising or a nice career in modeling after his life in San Andreas. And he is on the cover for Frontalot, which is actually kind of cool. So maybe he put down the guns and the violence and instead is now working as an actor, doing photo shoots and a bunch of glamorous things. All right, in the Mission Hood Safari, you might notice something really similar. You'll notice three characters riding out of Grove Street on BMX bikes, all dressed very similarly to three well-known GTA characters, Big Smoke, Ryder, and CJ. And this is reminiscent to the very first mission when they ride out of Grove Street. So again, the characters are dressed very similarly to the ones that we see in San Andreas. So that's pretty cool right there. And who knows, maybe these are just three individuals that are carrying on the legacy of CJ Ryder and Big Smoke in Grand Theft Auto 5. Maybe they saw the ways from those three legendary characters in San Andreas and wanted to continue the theme and wanted to do it in Grand Theft Auto 5 as well. The only time you can see this is in Hood Safari. There have been other references of players apparently finding CJ because they see NPCs that are dressed similarly to him. Maybe that he's wearing a similar outfit or maybe that he's got a similar t-shirt on. But I think this is truly the best reference and representation of CJ in GTA 5. Now, another Easter egg that I think proves CJ is alive is Lester is actually spying on him. So if you get into Lester's house, you can actually see there is a surveillance book with an old photo of CJ. Has Lester been spying on CJ since the 1990s? I think that actually might be the case here. I mean, we know Lester's a pretty smart, creepy, and intelligent guy. Why would he need to be following CJ? You know, was he tracking him for the government or something like that? I'm not too sure, but he definitely seems to be watching him. No idea why he would be. But one thing I think this does mean is that CJ is alive. You're not going to surveil a dead person. There's no need to do that. They're not going anywhere. So again, good news for the fact that CJ is likely still alive. Another sillier Easter egg that might prove he's alive is CJ's toothpaste. So maybe after all the crime, after all the hard work, after all the gang violence in San Andreas, maybe CJ settled down and wanted to work on his dental hygiene and started a toothpaste brand, because all throughout GTA 5, you can see tubes of CJ's toothpaste, which is pretty popular. You see them all over the place. So again, it really makes you wonder, did CJ drop his guns and instead pick up a toothbrush and a toothpaste and start his own toothpaste brand? Maybe, again, pretty silly, but I still think that that is pretty cool. All right, and the final Easter egg we're going to be looking at today comes from Vespucci Beach. There's a tattoo parlor that you can go inside, and one of the photos on the tattoo parlor looks like CJ. So was he just recently in a San Andreas tattoo parlor getting a tattoo? I think the face is pretty similar. I don't think it's 100% exact. Maybe it was a bad photo taken by the tattoo artist. I'm not too sure, but you can see CJ in there. And then there's also another store located nearby that also has like a mannequin or a photo of someone that looks kind of similar to CJ. Again, I'm not 100% sure if that's the case, but I still think that it is pretty awesome. And if that is true, looks like CJ has been hanging around Vespucci Beach. But anyways, that right there is 8 Easter eggs that prove CJ Carl Johnson is alive in GTA 5. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments section down below. Did you know any of these Easter eggs, or were there any new ones that you were just completely unaware about? I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments section down below. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.